here we are on set. At first glance, it's a normal day with a team of talent coming together to capture a scene. But on this set, we're doing something that has never been done before. Today, we're pioneering a new form of production, focus pulling using Apple Vision Pro.
This is insane.
A month ago, Apple released their entry into the mixed reality headset market with Vision Pro.
I am in the mountains pulling focus.
Yeah.
This is bliss.
But what you might not have noticed is that most of Apple's marketing of Vision Pro shows it being used primarily in the home. It feels like Apple's positioning for Vision Pro is initially targeting the consumer market. But our company, Strada, is a company that uses technology to improve workflow for creatives. And so we wanted to explore areas where we could take mixed reality out of the home. And we thought a great place to put this idea to the test was the role of a camera assistant. So the first thing we needed to do is find one.
My name is Amritha Mary, and I'm a first camera assistant.
I'd like to say there's two parts to being a first AC. So one is where you're in charge of the camera and make it as smooth as possible on set. And the second half of it would be focus pulling, which is this choreography on set between the actors, the camera operator, and the AC. I will admit that it intimidated me, the look of it. Was just like, I'm gonna look crazy on set. There was certainly a learning curve when I first put it on, but it wasn't that long. It took me like 5 minutes to get the hang of it. During camera prep, I put the Vision Pro on. It calibrated my eyesight, my fingers, how I control everything.
And I also think the role of a camera assistant is a great place to test Vision Pro because there's several common challenges associated with that job that perhaps a mixed reality device could help solve. So what are they? Well, first, modern focus pullers typically need access to their own monitor. They can't effectively do their job if they're sharing monitors with other people in Video Village. Second, the monitor needs to be high quality. Precision matters when pulling focus, which is why investing in a high quality monitor is super important. Third, their connection from the camera needs to be wireless so they can always see what the camera sees no matter where the camera is. Fourth, they need to be mobile. They are constantly moving around a cramped set, so they need to be able to move their monitor freely without being tethered to a cart, a stand, or even a power cable. Fifth, they need to be able to see all the data coming from the camera so they can relay information about format settings, status of media, time code, clip name, and batteries. Sixth, they need to control the lens wirelessly. While there are configurations where camera operators may pull their own focus locally, or some situations that use autofocus, today's experiment is for configurations that use remote follow focus control. And lastly, they need to be able to move quickly anywhere on or near the set. A camera assistant is constantly in motion, and in addition to pulling focus, they have to be able to change lenses, reconfigure the camera, manage menus, basically solve numerous problems as they arise. So the question is, can Amritha actually perform all the parts of her job while wearing a Vision Pro? And how will that impact the rest of the crew? We can go back to our list of challenges and see how Vision Pro addresses them. First up, a modern focus puller needs access to their own monitor. Apple integrated an impressive 12 camera array, some cameras facing inward and some outward. These allow a mixture of real life and video overlays to create a comfortable viewing experience. Once we replace an application window with a video signal, Vision Pro meets the need of having your own private monitor. Next, a focus puller needs a monitor that is high quality. Not only does Vision Pro have the highest resolution of any headset like this, it's actually one of the highest resolution displays ever made. One way to measure image clarity is by its pixel pitch, which is how close pixels are in horizontal and vertical orientations. The smaller the pixels, the tighter they can be packed together, resulting in higher resolution. Using both eyes, Vision Pro resolution measures over 23 megapixels. That's an active area three times that of 4K. In addition, Vision Pro pixels are capable of over 2,000 nits of peak luminance at over 90% of the P3 color gamut. What that means is the dynamic range and color reproduction of Vision Pro fits squarely in the professional space, meaning Vision Pro is an exceptional HDR viewing device. Oh, and a side note, if you wanted to buy a monitor capable of displaying 2,000 nits or more of P3 video in 4K, Vision Pro is actually the least expensive by a lot. So as far as a professional, high-resolution, affordable HDR monitor goes, Vision Pro checks that box. Next up, a camera assistant needs to view the camera wirelessly. Normally, cinema cameras use a third-party transmitter that consists of an SDI or HDMI box mounted somewhere on the camera body that can transmit an HD or 4K signal to nearby receivers. This produces a one-to-many transmission solution in which a camera assistant's monitor has one of those receivers.
Normally, when I pull focus, I would have a separate monitor just for me that I use with all my settings to pull focus. But in this case, that entire hardware was eliminated and we put a monitor into my Vision Pro, and it was just like another augmented reality element that I could move around and change the size of.
On this production, our main camera was an iPhone, which was convenient in that it's also part of the Apple ecosystem. We initially went with the built-in OS wireless transmitter protocol known as AirPlay. While this is a common solution for transmitting a computer or iPhone screen to a TV, it can't go to multiple devices simultaneously, and we needed multiple people to see the camera at the same time. So after exploring the App Store, we eventually came across a product called APowerMIrror. First, we connected both the camera and Vision Pro to the same Wi-Fi network. By the way, this doesn't require that the Wi-Fi network is connected to the internet. Then we powered APowerMIrror on both the iPhone and Vision Pro and set the app to local cast. The iPhone camera is then set to live broadcast. From there, we go back to the Blackmagic camera app, which is now being streamed to Vision Pro. Then we use AirPlay to mirror that Vision Pro signal back to an Apple TV, and then used an HDMI splitter to send the Apple TV signal to Video Village. With this setup, Amritha is now receiving a wireless signal from the camera and passing that signal wirelessly to Video Village, which is distributing it to multiple monitors over HDMI. To show an ultra-low budget solution, we used a $450 Samsung UHD TV mounted on a $90 rolling floor stand for our primary Video Village monitor. The HDMI splitter was only 15 bucks. A common focus pulling monitor is a Sony PVMA-170, which we also had, but it's receiving its signal from the HDMI splitter. In terms of size, AC monitors tend to be anywhere from 7 inches to 17 inches, but with Vision Pro, Amritha was able to set the size of her virtual monitor anywhere from 30 inches to even more like 4 feet. Now, I will say this configuration is less than ideal, and it requires several tools to make it work. There's a ton of opportunity for innovation because none of what we have working here was actually designed for this use, but it does work. So in terms of getting an ultra cheap, low latency wireless video signal to Amritha and Video Village, Vision Pro again checks the box. Next up, camera assistants need to be mobile. When working on a set, the act of getting scene coverage means the camera is constantly moving around. That means not only must the video signal be wireless from the camera, but the monitor itself must be wireless as well. Several of Vision Pro's frontal cameras help give it incredible spatial awareness.
When I was working on set, I set the monitor to be where everything was being shot, where the camera was, where the actors were, and I was grabbing equipment, I was grabbing batteries, and walking around set as you would during a production, and the monitor doesn't follow me, it stays where I set it.
So in terms of mobility, Vision Pro's spatial awareness makes it easy to remain mobile and take up less space than even having a real monitor. So we can check that off. So next up, camera assistants need to clearly see all the data coming from the camera. And the Blackmagic camera app has several options in which you can go to the settings menu, monitor, and choose the HDMI out option. Here, Blackmagic allows you to display monitoring configurations that differ from what's visible on the camera itself. Most of the time, an AC doesn't want a clean feed and prefers to have the status overlays surround an image, which is one of the options provided by Blackmagic. One of the most important elements of this overlay is having proper timecode, and for that, we use the Tentacle Sync E system, which allowed us to generate timecode which can be used to synchronize other devices. We attach the Tentacle Sync E to the iPhone over a USB-C dongle, and then go to the Blackmagic camera app settings, record, timecode display, and then select our Tentacle. You should check out episode 21 for a deep dive on what I think is the best audio timecode configuration for cinema cameras. But if you're shooting on an iPhone, the Tentacle solution works really well. But as soon as we introduce wireless sharing to Vision Pro, the system had a hard time retaining control while running these other apps. So timecode this way was not fully reliable, and I expect to see a lot of innovation in this area to make it really robust. But as far as seeing all the camera menus and timecode clearly, the Blackmagic camera app sets it up nicely with a secondary display that Vision Pro can receive. So that part does work, which means next up, camera assistants need to control the lens wirelessly. On this production, we were using the Atlas Mercury Anamorphic Primes with a Beastgrip depth of field adapter. You gotta check out episode 23 to see how we captured true anamorphic on an iPhone.
Focus pulling is an art form. What's in focus in the frame is an important part to storytelling. When I'm pulling focus between one person and the second subject, the speed of that or how smooth I do it and at what point of the conversation I pull focus, that makes the audience feel something, which you can't really achieve through autofocus.
So on this shoot, we used a Tilta Nucleus M wireless kit, which is available on B&H for $700. This low-cost kit gave Amritha multiple focus control options. First, when we used the standard iPhone lens, Amritha could control the focus of the iPhone itself over Bluetooth. Using the Blackmagic camera app, users can go to Settings, Accessories, Enable Bluetooth, and select the Nucleus, which gives her manual control of the iPhone lens for focus. But the Tilta Nucleus M kit also comes with an outboard motor so she can control manual lenses.
I mounted the Nucleus through lens supports on rods and I was able to pull focus as you normally would on any other camera build.
So as far as wireless lens control, Tilta solved that issue for both iPhone and the Atlas Mercury, and Amritha was able to set her focus marks and consistently hit them take after take. Which leaves us with the last challenge, which is that a camera assistant needs to move around the whole set and perform a number of jobs that don't actually require focus pulling. This means for the Vision Pro to work, you need to be able to do delicate, precise work with expensive tools. And on this production, we not only had lens changes, but we had to reconfigure the camera several times. In episode 18, we equipped our iPhone with professional accessories. But on this production, our mission was to use off-the-shelf technology that kept our camera budget super low while still giving us high-quality shots. So for camera movement, we used an Edelkrone Slider Plus, which retails for $449 US. This slider is unique in that its design allows for 2 times the travel distance than its actual footprint. It's also ultra lightweight, so we put it on a Sockler Cine 150 and we were able to get nearly 3 feet of travel distance. That made dolly shots like this really easy and fast to set up because we only had to move lightweight sticks. We also had one shot where the rig was up against a wall for maximum distance, and there's no way we could have gotten this with a larger rig. And Amritha was not only able to freely move around the set, but she was able to do it all while wearing Vision Pro.
After about 15 minutes, I kind of got used to it and I was focused on my job and pulling focus. And I even forgot that I was wearing it and I was asking everyone, like, how can I help? I don't know, it just became a part of me.
Right about now, I know that some of you are struggling with this whole thing. But it's vital that you don't let the stigma of augmented reality prevent you from exploring what could be a glimpse into the future. The assumption with AR today is that you're removed from reality and you're not engaged in real life. But we've seen in this test with Vision Pro, Amritha is truly interacting with real life and using AR while performing a physical job on a set. Now that's different. And to me, it means that when we add all this together, Apple Vision Pro and our off-the-shelf iPhone kit does, in fact, check all the boxes. So does that mean this is gonna become a standard overnight? No, of course not. That's not how this works. Even though this production was successful, there are numerous limitations that we had to mitigate, which is normal when things are this early. But it also means the AR production space has all the ideal conditions for innovation, which might begin with the most obvious, the weight.
The eyepiece was heavy and it did get taxing over a long period of time. It's kind of like wearing glasses, you forget about it and then the second you take it off, you feel the impact.
Make no mistake, Vision Pro becoming lighter with each version is a technological certainty, but I don't think that's the biggest challenge to overcome. And you know what? No matter what technology I find myself trying first, and I've been a part of the first of countless technologies over the years, the biggest challenge to overcome is always the same: behavioral change. Today, none of us really understands the full potential of augmented reality. And since we don't fully understand it, we shouldn't fully dismiss it either. Initially, we rely on companies that make these things, like Apple, to show us what they think about the new technology. But eventually, we use our own creativity and ingenuity to problem solve and innovate, which is what fuels adoption and eventually ignites change. If you've been at this for a while, you'll remember that it took 10 years for the transition from analog to digital to fully take hold. Many of you were early adopters, which meant you capitalized on being an expert in a new emerging market. But it also meant you bled the most. And there's going to be a lot of bleeding with Vision Pro. But imagine what could happen if camera manufacturers and monitor manufacturers and lighting manufacturers and follow focus manufacturers all began building AR tools that surface displays and settings controls and interactions that you can control with your eyes. The production set has always been ruled by hardware, which narrows its ability to be customized, and it costs the most. But software, that scales, and it's key to customization. If you squint even a little bit, you can start to see how Apple is a threat to the camera and accessories hardware space. And their power doesn't come from Vision Pro or iPhone or Apple Silicon. It comes from the App Store. The companies that see how to converge their hardware with the App Store marketplace are going to position themselves to thrive. And the users who figure out how to take advantage of them will save money and improve creative control. This experiment went very well, but we are literally at the top of the first inning. Vision Pro has a long way to go, but it's already giving me amazing ideas on how I'm going to build tools that I previously never thought possible.